Our next guest is a former supermodel who's become a pin-up girl in the battle against breast cancer. Claire Farwell worked alongside Cindy Crawford and Naomi Campbell in the 90s, but it's her decision to go public about her double mastectomy that's inspiring others now. Claire joins us now live from the UK. Thank you very much for joining us. Oh, sorry, Washington, I should say. Claire, thank
you
very much for joining us. Talk us through your decision. I mean, you must have had some pretty big reservations about removing your breasts after making a living, you know, trading off being beautiful and body conscious.
Well, actually, in a nutshell, I mean, there was no, you know, faffing about at all. When the doctor said that I had breast cancer, my initial reaction was take them off. Because I am very contented in my skin, even before I had the breast cancer. You know, we all strive to, you know, be a better woman and all that. And I was just like, take them off. And he said, no, you actually have to go through the process, and we recommend that you do, after this biopsy, that you do the lumpectomy plus radiation, and then we'll see from there. And then, of course, the lumpectomy showed the margins weren't clean. They'd did a central node biopsy without boring you. It was just taking a couple of nodes out under the arm to see if the cancer had spread. And the margins not being clear, he said, well, we'll do a mastectomy. And I said, well, here we are. This is what I said we should do from the beginning. And I said, I'll have both of them off. Thank you very much. Do you want to keep the nipples? Is there cancer in it? Could be. Thank you. Bye-bye.
And Claire, you decided then to have reconstructive surgery, and you did some very beautiful pictures afterwards. What was the response to those?
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, this response is continuing because here I am, you know, for Australia, and thank you for having me. The whole idea was, when I had a discussion with my husband about whether I should keep my nipples or not, back to that, which is quite a funny conversation to have with anyone, obviously with my husband. You know, it's like, hey, you know, what, let's just really focus in on a nipple and what it does. And I breastfed the children, and I'm like, well, it's up to you, to my husband. And, you know, then, of course, I made that decision. And, you know, I said, it's not as if I'm doing Playboy or anything that, you know, those days have gone of modelling. You know, I would actually become a journalist and things afterwards. So I wondered, you know, I said, well, you know what? Maybe I should do some pictures. So, you know, I mean, I always keep pretty fit, but my, I was in the gym, you know, every day for 2 weeks before I took those pictures. And, you know, I didn't know and set out with a plan of what I wanted to do, but it just felt right, and I knew how to get a good little team together, and the pictures, you know, were even better than I could have imagined, and it's just such
glorious.
A joy for me with my story. I think it says a lot. You know, and people like say, well, why did she go so big and this? Well, actually, they were the same size as when I started. I had obviously got a little slimmer too, but the whole point is the message is you are no less of a woman after a double mastectomy, and boobs or not, I'm still a woman.
And that sort of comes through loud and clear with those beautiful sort of images. They're very sort of empowering, I think. What advice would you give to other women who are going through a similar sort of situation that you initially found yourself in?
The most important thing is to be kind to yourself. I know that when we're alone, you know, to find... I mean, what I used to do was not bring a thought of cancer over the threshold of my bedroom. You know, just try, I mean, you know, to just listen to thoughts and try to just be really kind to yourself. And then secondly, every woman has their own story with cancer. Even though it's a similar diagnosis, people have their own choices. And that's when a woman really comes into her own and makes those choices. And no, it's not an easy time, of course not, ever, but to just know that she has her own story, you know, and God willing, they have, you know, the love and support of friends and family. And let people help out too, because some people like me as well like to, you know, do it all. So, yeah, and there's, you know, just there's a long list of other things I could say, but I'll just stop right there.
Claire, something that really stood out to me from the story you were telling is how you stood up for yourself and what you believed and said to the doctor, well, isn't that what I said all along? And you took some control of what was happening to you. How important do you think that was for you? And would you say that to other women too? You know, go with your gut, go with what you feel and make sure you tell the doctors what you want. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no, I would say, like a lawyer, doctors, get two or three opinions, you know, and take your time. A lot of the time the doctors want to rush you into things, you know, and there's this sort of medical jargon. Take your time. There are also, you know, find places, ask for breast cancer support groups, if that's the type of person you are. I would give my phone number to everyone. I mean, I am trying to just be a part of any, you know, social media, breast cancer, helping women. You know, some women do not want to go and huddle together and you know, some women don't want to go on a walk for 5,000 people, you know. So, you know, find someone to confide in, find someone else that's been through it. But above all, you know, just go through the stages and take your time. For me, I was 2 weeks just going, why, what did I do, when? Mm-hmm. And then it's like, okay, enough. You know, and for me, it was my family, the alternative medicine, finding the right doctor, and just above all, being kind to myself. And
good on you, Claire. You have an incredible.
And relax.
You have an incredible attitude. Thank you very much for joining us on Studio 10.
Thank you.
Phenomenal.
Thank you very much.
My best mate went through the exact same thing. She was tested for the breast cancer gene. They didn't find it. She fought and fought and fought to have a double mastectomy. They said, no, you're only 33. Let's try and save the breast. She was adamant. And when they took the breasts off, they actually found in the biopsy more cancer cells, which was absolute vindication. Mm. Exactly what Ange said, go with your gut because only you know your body.
Mm. On a serious note, she's just so inspirational. But on a more frivolous note, I am so jealous of those huge memories. I mean, I don't know about you girls, but my bra cups do not runneth over. I'm wearing the Wonder Bra, so-called, because when you take it off, you wonder where the hell your breasts went.
But, yeah. All right, don't go anywhere. This is Studio 10. After the break, should we lift the drinking age? And later,
Jonah Hill, cool. From Moneyball to The Wolf of Wall Street, Studio 10's Alicia Malone talks exclusively to Academy Award nominee Jonah Hill. Studio 10, we'll just check our shares and we'll be right back.